Welcome back. We're at Swindon Town, the county ground, on Super Sunday, where Liverpool are the visitors this afternoon.
Now, can you take a photograph of me kissing you?
No. It's about an hour down the M4 as you travel west out of London. The weather, well, it's been raining heavily this morning. We can expect around about kickoff time, sunny spells and showers, wind northeasterly, up to 15 miles an hour, and temperatures approaching 17 degrees centigrade. We've been outside once or twice, plenty of activity inside as well. That's the Swindon Town dressing room. Can't quite make out what's on the board there. Probably shouldn't either. There's the strapping, jerseys, a free match day programme, all the way around to the number four there. Squad numbers, of course. That's Mickey Hazard's jersey. And this is Liverpool. No shirts. They're giving nothing away. But obviously playing in green, or a version of the green, this afternoon. Well, we found out about Swindon, the Wiltshire town. Let's find out more about the club now. This is the definitive insight into Swindon Town, our match day programme.
Hello, everybody. My name is Jan Fjørtoft. I'm a Norwegian. Played the last four seasons for Rapid Vienna in Austria. Signed from Rapid this year for £500,000, and I'm gonna try to do my part to let Swindon survive in the Premier League.
The best moment in my career is playing for my country, playing for Norway. I'm very proud of being a Norwegian and always like to come back to play the home games at Ullevål Stadion, and we have done some good victories the last time. And one of the big goals now is of course to qualify for USA.
Bjørnevi. Nodded back in, off the bar and in. Norway lead by 2-0. Fjørtoft is the scorer.
If I wasn't a footballer, I think I would have done some work with kids or youth people, because I like doing things with other people, and I guess I will do some of this stuff. I couldn't sit in an office doing a normal job. I would have been out with people and working with them. I think it's very important for every human being to put his life in a perspective. And I think that's positive for me, because the most important thing for me about Swindon is to score goals, but it's not the most important thing in my life, and I try to make those two parts away from another, because everybody says that football is everything for me. It's not everything for me. I believe in God. I know other things are much more important than football, and I think that's why I have a good, relaxed relationship to football, and that's good for me.
Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow.
My motto in life is not just at the football pitch. I've taken it from Muhammad Ali, and he has it from a song for Whitney Houston, I guess. And it's, if I fail or I succeed, at least I live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity.
Because the greatest love of all is happening to me.
I think old Swindon looking forward to the Liverpool game is the biggest game so far in the season. and the players looking forward to the game. We are sure going to do our best. We'll do everything to beat Liverpool, and I mean that will give us the confidence we need to survive in the Premier League.
I played for Swindon Schoolboys many moons ago, probably 5 years ago now, five and a bit, in the days with Mike Hunt and Mike Summerby and Ernie Hunt. They had just got into the first team, but they used to come and train with the schoolboys, and I was a goalkeeper in those days. And spent my time bending down, picking the ball out of the net. The events of 3 years ago were bitterly disappointing to everybody. In fact, I'd been in Finland at the time of the playoff at Wembley, and I got back to Heathrow, and nobody knew the result of the game at Wembley, and eventually a porter told me that we'd won it 1-0. So, of course, I'm on cloud nine, celebrating with everybody else, and then within a matter of a few days, everybody was down in the dumps. They've had some personnel changes in key positions, and I think that will inevitably take a little time to settle down, but I'm looking forward to seeing that settle and produce some results. They like the big occasion, and there can be no bigger occasion in league football than entertaining Liverpool, surely. I think we've actually got a reasonable track record against Liverpool on the occasions we've met at the County Ground, in league cup games or whatever cup games, from a few years back. But this is a whole new ball game on Sunday, and I think the boys will be pumped up. John Gorman will have them ready mentally for such a game.
I've got to firstly get my place in the side, and if I do that, I'm looking forward to it. Well, they've played some good football over the last 4 years. The record speaks for itself. Obviously, in the Premier League, playing against the big guns, it's going to be very difficult for them. I think basically what we've got to do is just take our time and, the old cliche, take every game as it comes and see how we get on.
Premier League this time round means a lot, because we've been let down before. We've had the team, we've had the management before. Things didn't go in our favour, but this time we're up there and we can beat the best. And we're going to.
Well, I've supported them since they've been in the fourth division, and it's brilliant. It's really good. So much for the fans that have really supported them. Now we can get behind them and support them when the big teams are here.
They've bought some good players, and John Gorman's a good manager, and when Glenn Hoddle was there, he was a good assistant manager.
You should lose, frankly speaking, because, like, Liverpool miles better team, but we hopeful that we win. People who are just buzzing in this town, like, the season tickets, there's been nothing like it. Also, in a close season, you see people with the new Swindon Town shirts. Everyone just wants a piece of the action now.
Taking away the pain, you're bringing on back the good times. was the hopeful cheer of thousands of fans who had come from Wiltshire to see their third division heroes face mighty first division Arsenal in the final of the League Cup. Swindon took every opportunity, rattling the Londoners. They certainly deserved to go ahead through smart. But with 4 minutes left, Gould brought the Londoners back into the running. Arsenal, it seemed, were still to be reckoned with as extra time started. But the Swindon lads had really stoked their fire up. Mighty Rogers grabbed back the lead with a great goal. What a day for Swindon Town. Their supporters were ecstatic. But the scoring wasn't over yet. Rogers made it 3-1. Don Rogers was the hero of a team of heroes. Swindon Town had come to town and beaten one of the country's greatest football machines to win the coveted Football League Cup.
The way it went, the script couldn't have been written better. I mean, to win in extra time and for me to get both the goals was absolutely, well, tremendous. Well, the first goal was scrappy, really. But the second one was the one that everybody seemed to remember, obviously. It's running sort of 50 yards and rounding Bob Wilson, which everybody likes to make a mention of, and look at it in the back of the net, which finished the game. That was the important thing. I mean, once we went 3-1 up, the game's finished then. Bringing on back the good times,
taking away the pain. John, looking at training, one wouldn't guess from the spirit of the players that you've lost your opening two games in the Premier League.
You're right, absolutely right, and that's the spirit that we aim to keep here, which we've always had. And it'll stand us in great stead because, you know, we understand that the games that are the most important thing is winning matches, but you must always enjoy your training. It's so very important. And it's only two games in the season, so it's not all doom and gloom here by any means. We're looking forward immensely to playing Liverpool. It should be a great occasion for us and a game that we hope to really do well in.
I was going to say, in a sense, Liverpool will give you the chance to play football, which is what Swindon are renowned for.
Yeah, we probably, the last couple of games, we've been had to work at our physical side of our game even more, and possibly our football has not played as well as we'd like to have played. We've not put the flowing passes together again. We want to get that back again, and obviously playing a team like Liverpool might give us that opportunity. But, of course, the most important aim is, of course, to get a result, because we were very disappointed to lose the opening two games, and we felt that, as I say, the games were very close, and it could have went either way. We could have managed to come out with 2 points and 1 point in each game, for sure, and it ended up we've got nothing. But now we'll make us even more determined when we play against Liverpool on Sunday.
If you had to name one thing, what is it you'd say you've learned so far from the first week of the Premiership?
I think, obviously, we've not seen many teams anyway yet, but the physical and the fitness side of it is very, very strong, you know, and the speed is much quicker than probably it was even in the First Division. But in saying that, it's been two stellar teams that obviously worked very hard at that side of the game and are good at it, and we've had to try and match them. And we've done that as well, to be honest. We've matched them, but they were possibly a little bit stronger than us on the day, which is something we've got to really be better at this season to play in the Premier League, because it seems to be a lot depends on fitness and strength.
Wasn't it great to see those old black and white pictures? All the neutrals delighted to see Swindon up after 3 years, was it, Colin? 3 years ago. Thought you were up, and then the authorities said no and snatched it back. What was that like?
Devastating to hear it from a phone call from a radio reporter. It was the world stopped for a second or two, because we were led to believe that the decision would be a fine for the club, and it was no one really understood the full implications of it at that time. And as players, we were just going out and playing the games, and we thought the club would be fined, and if we won the game at Wembley, we'd playing the First Division as it was then, but
it's a remarkable achievement that managed to get it all back together and finally arrived, isn't it?
Yeah, but I don't think the club will ever be able to say that they've got it back together, because due to that we've had to sell players, and the team that we had then was exceptional, and we're going up on the crest of a wave, and the money that generated then, it's something that would take an awful long time to get back. Getting back as we did last year, so obviously the money, I think, has improved even from then, which will help the club. But it's something that will still rankle with a lot of Swindon supporters for a long, long time.